woman is one of the most powerful beings on earth. She is literally the embodiment of God in her essence. She endured things that I don't even think the black man could handle. That's why in today's video, we're going to look into the life of three melanated goddesses that fought for us. Because without these black goddesses, where would we as a black community even be? First, let's dive into the OG of the bunch. It was the late 1820s in Maryland. A slave owner angry at an enslaved black man was about to strike him with the weight. Right as the weight was coming down, the spirit of God came out of a little girl, and without thinking, she jumped directly in front of the man and had her skull fractured. Still, the little girl had no regret. That little girl's name was Harriet Tubman. This same woman would go on to free over 300 slaves,
be one of the first ever black women to be in the U.S. Army, and to help black people in so many ways.
Here's what sticks out about Harriet Tubman, though. She was roughly around 100 pounds, 5'1", with one or two rifles. It's obvious she was tapped in with divine spirits. There's also stories passed down on her walking through graveyards at night, calling ancestors, taking herbs from these graveyards of her ancestors to heal people. There's also stories of her having blackouts and getting visions. It's obvious this higher power, like magic, hoodoo, voodoo, and ancestors, whatever you want to call it, mixing that in with pure intention, helped her elevate to accomplish something that was unheard of, essentially, in the South, the heart of racism. That's one powerful example of the raw power that any black goddess can hone as long as she's in tune with the right frequency. She didn't need to kill no one. She didn't need to hate. All she did was keep that love and spirit of God for herself and her people, and she prospered. That's the beauty of the black woman. So now, let's look at another melanated goddess that beat the odds with just her spirit. It was the 1960s, in the heat of the battle for civil rights. Although the Supreme Court just desegregated schools, there was still a test that black kids had to pass to be eligible just to join the better funded white schools. Most black children failed, as our schools were heavily underfunded purposely. But in New Orleans, all the kids failed except five. One of those children was a Virgo woman by the name of Ruby Bridges. She is regarded as one of the first ever melanated people to not only be qualified, but to actually attend a desegregated school. At the mere age of six, she made that her reality. She was escorted by her mother and four US Marshals. She heard things no children should ever have to hear. She saw black children in coffins. She had food thrown at her. All this just for letting her light shine bright while having melanated skin. Somehow though, going through all of this and getting nothing but hate, she still did what our divine goddesses do best. Love. That's something our woman pushes through the world like no other. It heals us when we're weak. It empowers us to push limits, and it washes away all that hate that will otherwise consume us. While we're on this topic as well, I want to give a special thanks to Barbara Henry as well. She was the only person in the whole elementary school to treat Ruby like a human. She talked with her, teached her, and even played and ate lunch with her. She's an example that we all can come together when we operate from not ego or hate, but love. With that, let's talk about a black goddess that a whole state is named after. It was the early 1500s, a few decades before the tale of Christopher Columbus, because this nigga be lying. Off the west coast was an Amazonian peninsula. It was said to have strange creatures like dragons and phoenixes, only having divine substances like gold in its resources. And the craziest thing of all, the population was only black women. And the leader was a giant, divine, melanated being named Queen Khalifa. She was said to ride griffins and control the Mediterranean Sea at will. Once again, another black goddess tapping within her divine spirits and working elemental magic. Although people try to disregard it as a mere myth, it's clear that her and her divine empire existed through the rich herbs like cannabis, psilocybin, and these amazing creatures that still inhabit California to this day. Not to mention the giant black woman population of California. To take that a step forward, the conqueror of California, Hernando Cortez, himself tried to rename it to Santa Cruz when he conquered it, but he himself ended up using the name Khalifa, which means great ruler, or California, the land of the great queen. That's who we are and where we come from. Divine black royalty, not slaves and bitches. I tell you these three tales just to show you a glimpse of your power within you, Black Goddess. You have a holy divine spirit. So keep that love in your heart and get back to nature. Everything else will fall into place. I promise you. You are love. Your energy is ever going. Think about it. You bring another human into this world. You're born with this power. Nobody loves like the Black woman. We literally have shown all the other races how to love. That's why they're trying to weaponize toxic love against us. That's why they're putting all these females in front of you guys, because they know your worth. So they're trying to let you self-destruct because they have no power at all. I just wanted to make this video as an appreciation video for all the Black goddesses and to tell y'all a couple stories to hopefully empower y'all and help y'all remember who y'all really are. Because at the end of the day, they can't do no more harm to us. With that being said, I'm Alex the Virgo. I appreciate you watching. I'll see y'all in the next one. Love.